today it's time for another video because it is still December and I am planning on doing 31 Days of Red. And today I am doing a first impression with the Mint to Be from ColourPop. And no, this is not a red palette, but I am going to pair it with this lipstick from NYX. It's their Liquid Suede in Kitten Heels. And this is a really bright, fun red. And I think it will go perfect with this Mint to Be. It was like, when I first got this palette, I know that I wanted to pair it with that lipstick. And the palette looks like this. And I really, really love the Just My Luck palette from ColourPop. And this is the brighter, more pastel little sister to the Just My Luck. And I am going to do something with this. I'm not going to swatch anything because I'm just not doing that on my channel, where I do sometimes, but not today. And I want to do something really, really shimmery. And I think actually I want to take this Mint Tea because it looks amazing. And maybe take this Mojito Mami? Mojito Mami? In my inner corners. We'll actually see, and I think I want to take it. Okay, do I want to swatch? No, I do not. No. Okay, so I'm just going to prime my eyes and then we get started. And I can't decide if I want this to be a lighter look or a darker look, but it's a fun, bright lipstick. But we'll see. I will start with Demente. This one in my crease, and we will see how this goes. And I have not washed my brushes as normal. Maybe I can take this one. I don't know why I'm just not doing it. Maybe I should do it today. So I'm going to take this, and I'm going to take this in my crease, and now it's cat hair on it. It's like embedded in the brush. And now Astrid is doing something that I don't know what she's doing. And I don't think this brush was good. I take another brush. I was actually... It's cat hair in this one as well. It's like my life surrounded by cat hair. It sure is. Okay, this, I know this is like a minty pastel-y palette, and it feels like I really need to go in a lot with this shade. I am okay with that. It's nothing like unusual when it comes to these lighter shades. And Astrid is here. Now the question is, can she behave? Maybe not. So far, I am... Oh, she's here. And she makes the camera wobble. So far, I am okay with this shade. Even though I have gone in like 6 times, but... It is a shade, and Astrid, do you need to... clean yourself. Apparently she do. So maybe I should do my like channel to an ASMR cat channel. That is like the only ASMR I could stand. Like cat sounds. I guess that is like a proof that I am a crazy cat lady. And I can't, like, I don't know if I think this palette is bad for being this. That I need to go in with the shade over and over again. But at the same time, it is a light shade and it looks good now. I hope you can see it in the camera at least. But I've noticed that I am usually working with more like indie brand. And they, like, Shroud, and Menardry, they do really good pastel shadows. And I know that not like normal brands do. But I think this is kind of okay. And do I want to have it light or do I want to try to make it a little darker? Because I'm thinking about using these two and like deepen down my out corner with this one. And then do like a half cat crease. We want that, and I think I have cat hair on my nose now. Okay, I actually like this shade. Maybe I should do something. I think I will take this ice cold and see what happens if I put it in my crease as well. Because this seems a bit darker, so I'm guessing it will be a little bit more pigmented, and it is. Okay, so I at least think this was a good idea. So I actually think I will go in with this Chill Factor and just take it a little bit on my outer corner to get a little bit this look. And sometimes I wonder, English, why are you such a strange combination with letters? Okay. So far, we are good. Okay, I did swatch a little bit. And I don't think, because I swatched this Freshman and Mint Tea, and they felt really, really creamy. So I might not need to use Glitter Glue. I'm just going to try to take this Chill Factor a little bit darker. This doesn't want to be the dark that I want it to be. Just really hope that it will blend together with the shimmers good, because if it won't, I'm going to be sad. So I will try to find two clean brushes. Okay, I'm going to try to use like only the other side of the brush, and then I'm going to promise you and me that I'm going to clean my brushes after this. So I'm first going in with Freshman, the darker one, and taking it just like a strip, like a line here. I might, if I can restrain myself to playing it easy. Okay, the only thing now that I see is like a little problem for some, for me, no. The shade that I deepened down my crease with is really coal toned. They blended together good, but I need to take like the matte shade over to do it that way. So like that, and then I'm going in with the Mint Tea and I'm trying, ooh, this got stuck to my brush really good. I'm going to put that in here, and I don't know how much of a difference this will be, because it feels like this Mint Tea is so much more like creamy and flaky. And maybe it's just a brush, maybe it wasn't a good brush. Do we have another brush like this brush? I'm going to try this instead and take it, because the other brush was kind of flimsy. And do you know what? The other shade that I took in the middle was like a total waste of space. I think I will just go in with this Mint Tea all over. But this feels like a little bit more like flakier. I think I would have done my or cut my crease. I think that would have made it better. I'm just going in with dark matte here again. But it's now like, I want to do the same on this eye, even though I took Minty on my whole lid, because what if it changes something? So I'm going in with Freshman. Just like that, and then I'm not going to blend this out that much. I'm going to go in with Minty. And I don't know if you can see like the difference between these two, because now I have two similar brushes and this is so much more flakier and it's not like that opaque as Freshman was. So actually I think I liked Freshman more. Who would have known? But I still think you can see like a little difference where the Freshman is under. So maybe this was a good idea after all. Okay, so I actually think I like this. I think it will look super cool with either Mojito Mami or Play It Cool in my inner corner. I'm going to swatch them before I take something in my inner corner. But yeah, as normal, I'm going to take away the fallouts, fix my base, and then I come back. So it's only time. It's only time. It's only the under eyes left. And of course the lips. And I think I want to go in with first this one, Dementa. ColourPop, you often do this, I think. You name things that I don't know. So I'm going to take that one and then I'm going to take Chill Factor just to connect. We do it really simple here on my channel. What was that for kind of thing to say? I don't know. First, I was actually a little bit worried that this was going to be this wouldn't show up, but it does, so that makes me happy. Okay, and then I'm going in with Chill Factor. Take it out here. I am not super impressed by this shade, but we will talk more about that soon. So okay, I will put on my mascara and something in my waterline and then the lippy, and then we are finished with my first impression with the Mint Chibi. So this is the finished look, and I don't know about the lips. I think it works. So for my waterline, I use LA Girl Shockwave in Fresh. I was like, it's the name, but it has a name, shade. And of course, the Kitten Heels from NYX. And I think actually I'm going to do like a little review on this one, because I've used so many palettes from ColourPop and I like know how their shadows work and what is a good shadow and what is a bad shadow. I did forget something. I want an inner corner highlight. I think I will take this Play It Cool actually. Pinky. Pinky on the go. Yeah, this worked. Well, this worked good. Okay, so this is the finished look. So I've used a Mint Tea and Freshman, Ice Cold, Chill Factor, and Demente. The only thing is, it has like a lot of kick up in this pan. I think some of ColourPop's shades are like super, super much kick up, and some are not. Maybe I should scooch a little bit so I can hold it up so I am still in frame. And where should I start? We can take the first shade I used, the Mente, and it worked really good if I put it in my crease like 6-7 times. Again, it is a light pastel-y shade, so you need to work it up, but it still feels like it keeps the color. I hope you get what I mean, but like it doesn't change color or like fade or anything, so if I just packed it on, it looked really good. And this Ice Cold was much better. It was really nice. I think this could look really, really good together with Chill Factor like on the lid and do a whole matte look. But I like this one as well. Chill Factor, I don't know. It felt like a little bit hard to get like even, and also like I had to pack it on. If I started to like blend a little bit, it feels like it faded. So I'm not super impressed by Chill Factor. I think Ice Cold was much better. And then for the shimmers, this Freshman, that was really smooth shimmer. I really liked it. And I like don't know even if you can see it under there. I have no idea. What do I have here? So yeah, it's good. I really liked it. I thought I was going to like the Minty more, but it was a little bit more flaky. I think that would have been so much better if I would have taken a glare glue or glare primer or sprayed it. So they were a little bit different. I did talk too much, the memory ran out, but where was I? Yeah, I think the Freshman was much more controlled than Mint Tea. I don't know. I think I can like hint the Freshman under a little bit. I have no idea how I will get it to show on camera. And then Play It Cool that I took in my inner corner. I don't think I can say that much about the shade that I took in my inner corner, but I like it. So yeah, this is my first impression look with the Mint TB palette from ColourPop. Would I recommend it if you like the colors? ColourPop's 9 pan monochromatic palettes are not expensive at all. They are good for the price. I think that all of the 9 pan palettes I've tried, they have some shades that are like amazing and makes up for the whole palette. In this palette, I actually think it might be this Freshman and Ice Cold. But with that said, I haven't tried this one, so it might be really good, that one as well, but I like it. Maybe we could like compare it to Just Malak, that was their first. I think these two would be really cool to like do a look with. What am I doing? I never do things like this. But now I'm going to. The one thing I like with the Mint TB, it's really like Mint TB. So these are the Mint TB, and Jesus, how can this be hard? I'm holding up two palettes. Okay, so these are the two next to each other. I think you could do a really like cool looks with these two together, and I almost poked the shade. So yeah, I love this better though, but I have nothing to complain about with this one. It is $12, I think. And yeah, the only thing might be like, I don't know, this Get Fresh. Maybe it is a really good shade, but it looks really, really light. And I am super pale, so for me it wouldn't be like any problems at all, but I am not the only one that is going to use this palette, but I like it. I have nothing to complain about. It's not my favorite monochromatic palette from ColourPop by far, but I don't mind having it, and I think all the colors that is in this looks good in this. And it's no press glitter in this one. I really like it. And do you know what? That was actually all for this video. And I really hope you liked it. And I will put this little red lipstick into my other red lipsticks. So it might come one more video with this lip. I don't know. Or should I take it out? I will see how we'll do. But yeah, this was my first impression with the Mint to Be. I really hope you like this video. And if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do. Because I'm going to be here a lot the next couple of weeks. So yeah, I really hope you liked it. And I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye!